We are live, we have breaking news, and I need, whatever you're doing, I need you to stop right now, and this is a very important video. We've all heard about the devastating events that have happened in Kentucky, but now Queen Anne's County is doing something to help. And we have Chesapeake Charities with us today, and they're doing Operation Christmas Cookies, and we want them to tell you all about the amazing stuff they're doing to help and how you can get involved, and we need you to be involved today, everyone you know. So start liking this video, comment, tag some people, share this video everywhere, because we need all the help we can get. And I have Chesapeake Charities with me here today. So ladies, could you please tell me about Operation Christmas Cookies? Linda?
Absolutely. So I'm Linda Kohler, Executive Director of Chesapeake Charities. And we came up with the idea to spread a little cheer during the holidays to the people who are most affected by the tornadoes that hit in Kentucky last week. And so what we're asking folks to do is when you're making your Christmas cookies this year, if you would make an extra dozen or two to share and deliver them to us before next Wednesday, the 21st, we will then transport them down to Kentucky. We're going to stop at 5 different locations, and we're also collecting toys, unwrapped toys, and teddy bears or other stuffed animals, and clothing, warm clothing for the people who really have nothing down there. As much as you all can give or want to help with, or as little, even a small donation will be helpful. And so we will then drive this stuff down and stop at each of the cities and deliver the cookies and the gifts, make some hot cocoa, coffee, and apple cider, and just give the folks a moment to enjoy the holiday season and get their mind off of what they've been living. And so we ask for your help to do that. And our board chair, Audrey Scott, is here to kind of explain why Chesapeake Charities gets involved in these things.
Well, Chesapeake Charities, kind of, this is our modus operandi. Reaching out into the community, identifying needs, and most often always we do our own local communities. We represent 9 counties in the Chesapeake area, Chesapeake Bay area. But this is a need that extends beyond our borders, and everyone is asking, what can we do to help? And we just thought it would be nice to bring a little touch of Christmas to the folks that have lost everything, lost their homes. They're not going to be in the kitchen baking cookies. And we thought that that's something we could do. And it has exploded in beyond the cookies. We're collecting also warm coats, hats, gloves, mittens. We're collecting toys, new toys, and gently used coats and hats. And we also had a tremendous, something that we hadn't thought about is Commissioner Helen Bennett is going to donate dog food because the dogs and the animals, the pets also are in need. So people are being very creative, and we know that this is going to evolve into something even greater than that we originally thought about. But with your help, that's going to happen, and it's a very, very, very short turnaround time. So we need you to focus on this and do it now, and we will post the location for the drop-off, and as soon as you can do it, we would appreciate it very much. We especially want to thank our County Administrator Todd Mon, because he helped us get this interview scheduled, because without this interview, it's hard to reach people, and this is something we want to thank Queen Anne County TV, QACTV, for accommodating us today.
And we also reached out. So one of the things Chesapeake Charities does is we connect people, and everyone's welcome to help. And we thought, who do we know who can get the word out better than anyone else? And the first name came to us was Lucy Cruz, because she had organized face masks for Maryland when the COVID-19 pandemic hit. And we honored her as our Volunteer of the Year in 2020. So Lucy, you want to tell us how you're going to help?
Sure. Well, first of all, I'm going to be riding along with Linda down to Kentucky to those 5 locations where we're going to be delivering these items. But I also replicated the information out on social media. I tend to be a social media hog, and I found that that's the best way to mobilize volunteers. So I believe this morning I sent it out to about 14 different Facebook pages across the state of Maryland. And so already we're getting responses back from that. So I think we'll have plenty of things to deliver when we get there. And I also bring with my experience was that I was on the ground helping during the tornado that hit Bay City about, I guess it was 4 years ago. And as a result, I know what it means to people. When you show up before actually the even official response organizations can be there, because they're still organizing, when you show up in this capacity, the people literally just fell into our arms because they said we were bringing them hope that their life could be back to normal. So that's basically what it means to me, is to give people hope.
Wonderful. And so the way that you can help, we have space at our office, which is in the Chesapeake Bay Business Park in Stevensville, 101 Log Canoe Circle. So Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, you can bring these items to us and we will get them ready. You could donate a truck. You could offer to drive with us if you would. We could take firewood. Many of these towns still don't have power. Certainly the clothing. You could also make a financial donation, although we're not really asking for your money, we're asking for your time. But if that's the way you could give, we are at www.chesapeakecharities.org, or you can email us info@chesapeakecharities.org, or call us 410-643-4020. Any way you can help would be appreciated.
And we've had some people that have joined in late, so I just want to let them know kind of why we're doing it. But why Christmas cookies? I thought it was really cool why you guys had chose that. So could you explain that?
So I'm a baker, and throughout the year, I will bake cookies. Chocolate chip are, I think, the crowd favorite. But I will deliver them, and they always get a wonderful response from people, and they comment to me how much that meant. So I just thought, with people who have nothing right now, what a nice way to just say that they're cared about. And, it's a small thing, but it's something we could do.
And it's also Christmas, and Christmas cookies kind of, Christmas and cookies kind of go together. And I know myself, I've just finished baking a whole lot of cookies and using two of my mother's recipes. And so that's all nostalgic, and it's kind of what Christmas is all about, is family and love. And I think cookies is the best way to say it.
And how long is the drive going to be for the group going down?
So we think it's about 10 hours to the first stop, and then we'll go on and, a couple more hours. So we're going to stay at each place for a while so that we can set up hopefully a food truck. So if anyone wants to donate a food truck or connect us to a food truck down there, that would be helpful. But we'd like to be able to make some hot cocoa and sit with the people, potentially set a little fire, and just spend some time before we go on to the next location. And then we'll be back by Christmas Eve, the 24th.
Great. Well, Lace, thank you so much for stopping in. Thank you for doing, this is amazing. I know it's Chesapeake Charities, the organization, is doing a lot of work throughout the county numerous times throughout the year. This is just one more thing they're doing. So please get involved. Again, this is very important. Please share this video as much as you can. Every group every family member that bakes, let them know what's going on so you can be part of helping Kentucky as they're going through a horrible time. I can't even imagine what it's like trying to celebrate Christmas after all this has happened. But this is a little way that you can help brighten spirits for someone that's so far away that you've never even met. So please get involved. Thank you for watching. Share this video. Enjoy your Christmas as we say goodbye to Chesapeake Charities, because they're going to have a very long trip taking your cookies down soon. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.